Hello, Shamrock students. It's been quite a while since you've been in these hallways. Here I am in the senior hallway, lonely around here. We miss having you here. I know that this has been, at times, a frustrating deal for everyone. For you, for those of you that miss that community of students that you have, the community of friends that you have, not being around them every day, having that human contact with them, the teachers that work so hard every day to help educate you and to provide you with a great Catholic education. For your parents as well too, as they have now become a primary teacher for you or helping you at home trying to get through this process. And I know that we had a real abrupt end to things and where we just, cut it off and there was some hope that we would be able to get back into our building again, but it's become really obvious that that's just not going to be able to happen for this year. And for our seniors, I'm just bitterly disappointed for them. So many of them with the extracurriculars, whether it was the district music contest coming up, the sports seasons that were coming, all the time and effort that had been put into those things, and to now not be able to have that. This morning I was reflecting back on just fact when I used to be a basketball coach and to think that I wouldn't have a season. And that's just really not even in the realm of possibility. No one ever thinks about that. No one ever thinks about not being able to come to their school during the school year. And so, we're doing the best that we possibly can. And that's what we're built for the Shamrock Catholic education. Sometimes we have to roll with the punches. We got to go with it, and we got to try to make the best out of what we have. And so that's what we're asking you to do. I wanted to provide a little bit of clarity for you about the grading process going forward. We have your third quarter grade. And so the plan is for the rest of the school year, for this second semester, is that your third quarter grade will count as 70% of your semester grade. The fourth quarter grade will count as for 30% of your semester grade. Here's the important thing that I want you to understand. No one will do worse than their third quarter grade that they had in that class, okay? So I'm gonna say that again. You're not gonna do worse than your third quarter grade, but there is one real important thing to that though. You have to give an effort. You have to make sure that you're turning in the things that you need to do. And obviously that's because we're still trying to do a great job of educating you. You also want to still learn. That's what it's all about. So you need to complete the task that you're doing, okay? And you're not gonna do any worse than you did in the third quarter. And you still have an opportunity with the 30% of the fourth quarter, you have an opportunity to even improve on what you did during the third quarter, okay? So I think that's a scenario where in the situation that we're in is something that is amicable for everybody, okay? Next week is Holy Week. And we're used to having the things that we do here, whether it be where we all get together for our Stations of the Cross. We haven't been able to do our all school masses. I miss in the chapels on the Tuesdays and Fridays of having students come in and celebrating Mass with us. So I really want you to take some consideration into how you're gonna celebrate Holy Week. I would suggest taking out your Bible and reading one of the four Gospels. It's not that you have to do it all in one sitting. Take some time, go through it, read a little bit at a time, and just reflect on the teachings of Christ that are in there. Look at how you can relate that to your own personal life, and especially focus in on the Last Supper, Good Friday, the crucifixion of Christ, and then the resurrection as well. But possibly take some time on that. We'll be sending some resources to you. Mrs. Caranda, Mrs. Dorman are putting together some great resources that we'll be sending out early next week. But I hope that in the midst of all this, that you and your family can take some time for what is really important, and that is the proper celebration of Holy Week. The last thing that I would tell you is that for a SCOTUS student, one of the things that, I remember back to when we started the STEAM program. And one of the things that I wanted our students to become is to have that chance to do some critical thinking, but also to be problem solvers. And right now, that's the position that you're in. I know that some of you have felt like you've been inundated with assignments and those things, and we're in a environment that we're not used to. So it's really incumbent upon us to be problem solvers at this time, to be able to figure things out, to also become self-sufficient on things. These are traits that will help you as you transition through SCOTUS, or if you're seniors, they'll be transitioning on into college next year. The idea to be self-sufficient, to be a problem solver, are all traits that will help you as you keep going, eventually have jobs of your own, have families of your own, because realistically, that's what it's all about. And in this situation that we found ourselves in, man, did we have to become problem solvers really fast. And I'm very appreciative of everyone's efforts, especially our teaching staff's efforts, to put together an educational program that we feel that could still provide you with a good, solid Catholic education. So with that, again, I hope you have a great Holy Week. I hope to put together another one of these videos in the near future. But God bless, stay safe, stay healthy, and we are praying for your families, and we hope that you are praying for all of us involved with SCOTUS Central Catholic as well, too. Take care.